Where is everyone?
It seems I'm not very popular with Rita.
So?
Well, if you're not popular with Rita in this place, you're not popular with anyone. When's she getting out of solitary?
I'm not sure. Why?
Mr. Adams, I have a favor to ask of you.
This note you want to get to Connors. What's it about?
A deal. She seems to have a vendetta against me.
Why?
Well, I don't know. Perhaps she thinks I want to be top dog.
Do you?
Do you really think that would interest me?
No, but what interests me is what I'm going to make out of this.
Let's just say our friendship could be mutually advantageous.
Okay. I want to know about the boat trip. What happened? Everything?
Agreed.
And the note up to Connors?
Well, I thought Merle might hide it in Rita's food.
She's not on kitchen duty.
She could be.
I'll arrange it.
Another reporter. What are you telling them?
Nothing.
If I told them the truth, can you imagine how they'd report it? Wentworth officer goes joyriding with prisoners.
Who is now missing, possibly dead.
Precisely. At least Nancy McCormack insists that Joan was last seen heading off for help.
Oh, I hope she makes it. God help any passive nature lovers who come across her.
I'm worried about Marty and Delia. This won't look good on their records.
You know, I never thought I'd say this, but if Joan walked in here right now, I'd run the flag up and cheer.
Oh, excuse me, I was about to knock.
What is it?
I wanted to see Mrs. Morris. We need another hand in the kitchen, and I thought I'd roster Merle Jones on, if that's all right.
Yes, that's fine.
Right. Oh, excuse me. Any news about Miss Ferguson?
Not yet. Thank you, Mr. Adams.
He's really wallowing in it, isn't he?
Trouble is, on paper, he looks like the golden-haired boy.
Oh, if only the department could find out what he was really like.
They have. My report states that, in my opinion, Mr. Adams is not good officer material.
For all the good it'll do.
There you go.
There you go.
Oh, come on, Ronnie.
All yours for a few fags.
Lavatory paper we can steal for ourselves.
I've got printer's ink, 3 colours.
All right, we'll trade that. 4 cigarettes.
It's a package deal. 6.
Pay up.
Right.
There you go.
1 minute you're paying out fags for nothing, next thing you're getting them for nothing. I can't keep up with it.
Yeah, neither can we. Listen, we are losing badly on this.
Oh, think of the long-term investment.
Can you use this?
Oh, certainly.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Well, what are you going to do with all this stuff? I'm having a tip.
Shovel.
Next.
Perfect.
What's going on?
Oh, just a little bit of private enterprise.
That doesn't answer my question.
Well, that's because it's none of your business.
Yet.
But I'm so curious.
Ah, pity.
I've been looking for you. Oh, look at all the pretty paper.
I could ask Merle to get to the bottom of this.
What? You the career woman? Betsy and I have already paid a full week's protection money. If anything happened to us, everyone would lose trust. That'd be very bad for business, wouldn't it?
Come on.
See you, see you.
Bye, Merle.
All right. What are we going to do with this pile of junk?
Create.
Oh, Laurie.
All you have to do is pour this in the meals that are going to solitary.
Why?
To make them feel bad for being against us.
They'll do it?
It should put them in the infirmary for a couple of days.
But Nancy, she's not against us, is she?
It won't hurt her, Merle. But you have to make sure you put it in all 3 meals, understand?
I guess so. I'm not stupid.
No, I know you're not stupid. But you have to do it without being seen, just like Captain Marvelous.
Ah, Captain Marvelous.
Now, you don't let anyone see you. Anyone.
Jones, report to the kitchen.
Rightio. Marvelous!
Don't run! Are you sure she's right for the job?
It's only a note.
It just seems so unfair. I mean, you study, you do your best and really, really care about the job and everything still goes wrong. Just...
Stinks. No, thanks.
Can you imagine how reports are going to read?
Yep. We went out with 1 ship, a skipper, 4 prisoners and an officer, and we came back with nothing.
Don't remind me.
Our only chance is that the Board of Examiners mightn't believe it.
What do you think you do? I mean, will you go back to the Navy?
What do you think? They get wind of my last assignment, they wouldn't put me to sea in a paddle boat. What about you?
Oh, I suppose I could always enter a convent.
You two are having a long break. If you're not careful, you'll have unpunctuality added to your reports as well.
Oh, as well as what? You never miss a chance to sink the boot in, do you?
It's not that at all. I'm just saying what everyone thinks. Neither of you have made the grade.
And you have.
We'll know tomorrow when our reports are issued. Mrs. Reynolds is very concerned.
What about?
Joan.
What do you mean?
Joan can look after herself.
Then where is she? If you ask me, she's at the bottom of the bay or a cliff. Mrs. Reynolds thinks so too.
How do you know that?
She told me. I mean, Joan wouldn't have much chance against Connors and Jenkins after you two deserted her.
Hey, Del! You...
Watch the temper.
You want me to put it in the freezer?
What do you think? Merle!
Yeah?
Never mind. Tanya, you can get the meals for solitary.
I'll get them.
He said me. Oh, where are the forks?
Out there.
That time.
Aren't you ready?
Yes, but look, you can have these. Tanya, come along. Trade duty for isolation.
Tanya! Hang on, these are for solitary.
Not anymore, they're not. Now come along, move.
Hey, hey!
What is it?
Aren't they going to the pound?
What difference does it make? Now come along, cutlery, Merle, cutlery.
I'm glad you're the one who's got to tell him.
Wait at the gates. I want some information.
I'm a real bad choice for information. You get sort of cut off from things up here.
Tell me about Joan Ferguson.
Well, she's about mid-40s. She looks like a truck driver in drag.
What happened to her?
We told the governor everything.
I want the truth.
Did Randall send you up here?
No.
Will you let her and the cops worry about Ferguson? It's got nothing to do with you.
If Joan Ferguson's dead, it'll be on my conscience as much as yours.
Only if I killed her.
It was planned from the start, wasn't it? I thought the whole thing was a damn mess, but it was a plan. Delia going overboard, me going after her.
You can't prove that.
To hell with proving it. I just want to know. Delia and I busted our guts to get you work experience and you just rubbed our faces in it.
That's not true.
Isn't it? Well, our reports are out tomorrow, Connors.
Look.
Nah.
It wasn't. Mr. Jackson, I left Ferguson alive. And I hope she comes back.
What are you doing?
Helping?
You're not on kitchen duty.
Profiteroles, perfect.
For what?
For Mel's surprise party. And you are going to make some, aren't you?
What? Profiteroles? Well, what about my budget? And for that matter, what about Merle?
What about her?
Well, all the trouble she caused. Between her and fellows, it's like trying to cook in the Blitz. I had them rostered off.
Oh, I wondered why she looked so dejected.
She did. Well, I'm afraid there's nothing I can do about that.
Even though we're trying to make her happy.
Wilkinson, what are you doing in here?
Oh, well, we're just doing some PR, Mr. Adams.
Out. Now.
Thanks anyway, Mr. Pringle.